My name is Dee Edwards.
My name is Michael Edwards.
And we are Kingdompreneurs. We're entrepreneurs and pastors here in Birmingham, Alabama. We're so excited to be here on today. Thank you so much for having us.
As I mentioned, just talk about what you all are doing, the services that's available, the COVID-19 small business grants.
So as small business owners and ministry leaders in our community, we recognize there was a need to do our part as much as possible. God has definitely been a blessing to our lives. And so we wanted to chip in a small portion of what we had to help other small business owners to continue to pursue the dreams that God placed in them. And so we're doing that, and we'll have a gift of love in conjunction with it. I'll let my wife speak a little bit more to the process of how you fill out the application and things of that nature.
Okay. Yeah, we're very excited to be able to contribute to the small business community. What we have done is use social media as a way to raise funds. Also, our ministry, the Celebration Church, Accurate Tax Services, and also Kimberly Mason's business as well, Sweet Treats and Ice, have all come together. We have had private donors as well to come together to help us with raising this fund. We are so used to bringing small business owners and entrepreneurs together during the holiday season to be a blessing to them. And so the best way that we could do that this year is by hosting this small business holiday grant. The process is very simple. They can go to www.smallbusinessholidaygrant.com, and it's an application process. It's not too strenuous. Our goal is to be able to provide between $100 to $500 to about 20 to 25 small business owners and entrepreneurs. They don't have to live in a certain area. All that we ask is that the business be established for at least one year and be 18 years or older.
Yeah. The person running the business.
Yeah, and pretty much just be affected by COVID-19 and have an immediate need.
There are a lot of businesses that are still waiting for more federal money. They need help. So any little amount of money that they get, I'm sure they will be appreciative of the help. Would you agree?
Yes. Oh, yeah, we totally agree. And that was the reason why we decided to come together with our support system with raising the funds. We realized there were people who did not get approved for PPP, the EIDL, or other federal programs, so we wanted to figure out a way to contribute. And then there are some who did qualify for it, but still there's a need. Yeah. So as a ministry and as entrepreneurs, we just feel like it was our responsibility to be able to help the small business community.
Because the government did their part, but this is a thing that we all could do together, because like my wife says, some people got the loans, but it still wasn't enough. And the effect of COVID-19 affected people in so many different ways, because small business owners, when they had to shut down and they were still paying people out, their income was affected because people wasn't shopping with them. People wasn't doing business with them, and they still had to take care of their household. So we wanted to ensure that the people that we know in the community were able to still, have hope and still continue to strive, even if they had to pinch at the pennies, but they got something to look forward to. Yeah.
Okay, is there anything else that you all have?
No, we just want to encourage everyone to apply. They have until December 7th to apply, and then winners will be notified via email, telephone call. We may show up where they are. Also, we're going to do the Gifts of Love that is hosted by our church, and so we'll also just notify them that way as well.
So, and just to let you know, the Gifts of Love is where we have a plethora of gifts from TVs, just different things that we're going to be giving out, and people can actually, they'll be on the live, and it'll be like a telephone where they'll be on the live, we'll ask a question, if they get the answer right, we'll tell them, hey, they won this product, and then they can come pick it up on the next available day. So we're just trying to do as much as we can just to give people some hope and help them endure through these times that we've all had to endure through.
Yeah, and we definitely have to thank Walmart. We have a partnership with Walmart, and so all of the items that we're giving away, it comes from Walmart, and we have been able to establish Joseph Closet. And so with Joseph Closet, we're able to give just about any and everything away, from electronic items to furniture to clothing items.
Kitchenware, toiletries. I mean, it's amazing, man. We we just actually got it up and officially running within the last 3 months, and we have already been able to service over 80 folks. And it's continuing to grow, continuing to grow.
We have 50 people that's on the waiting list for us to fulfill. But we are going to Walmart weekly, two or three times a week, in order to get the items that they donate to us. So we get them in large quantities in pallet forms. So if there is anyone that's in need for anything, like, we are definitely available, and our church and our businesses have the different resources that are available.
At www.josephclosets.com.
Yep. So we just want to thank everyone for their support for the Celebration Church, Accurate Tax Services, Sweet Treats and Ice, and just
Pink Sweet.
The Pink Sweet, the Pink CBD store.
The Connect Social Hub. Y'all look out for it. If you're in the Center Point area, we're opening up a social hub for small business owners that will be available in 2021.
That's right.